So here we are. This is episode 3 of the Cleanup Cast, our monthly kind of chill out podcast where Keaton and I talk about anything and everything as we play Viscera Cleanup Detail. And if you've been following the Cleanup Cast and you've been listening to us pretty much every month, you'll notice that we've pretty much done everything here, right? I mean, there's not much left to do.
Yeah, there we got to do the
There's a lot of
bits to clean up left, but yeah, we have the we have to clean up the blue spark things on the floor and some blood.
There's a shitload of blood in this main area here. There's like
bloody
footprints. I think what we should do is bring in some buckets and just kind of cane this area maybe. Because I don't think we need to come down here to clock out. So if we take care of this area first, and we'll just kind of work away through maybe.
Yeah.
All right, sounds good. I'm going to have to jump up here because my feet are bloody as hell. Yeah, just... Am I... What the hell? Get off my feet. There we go. I think I'm good. All right, and then I had to go through. So yeah, this is... We pretty much talk about random subjects when we do this. And I think this week we're going to talk about Mr. Robot, the TV show.
Yeah, yo.
We have both seen it, and we've been wanting to talk about it for a while, and I guess what better opportunity than right now when we're both together playing Viscera Cleanup Detail. And did you get these buckets out? There's already a few here. Maybe you did these last time, because our progress is saved, so...
Yeah, no, I just picked up a new bucket.
Yeah. But yeah, Mr. Robot Man, that was a TV show that kind of aired a few months ago. It was on the USA Network in America, I believe.
Yeah.
And, man, that was an interesting show. It was like, going into it, I guess the basis is that it was kind of billed as like a hacker slash thriller, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Was that a vibe you got from like the advertising of that show?
Well, I mean, the marketing for it was very much technology centric and like, you know, ooh, it's about hacking and like, it's very much seems inspired by like Anonymous, you know, the whole we are anonymous hackers, you know, and we are a centralized unit of people who like to, you know, do what hackers do.
pretty much.
I guess the way that I saw it was like, or like, what I thought it was going to be at least was some kind of silly take on the whole hackers thing. Maybe like the movie Hackers, but like...
Yeah.
I mean, here's the thing. Like, my knowledge of TV shows when it comes to hacking is like the stupid clips that you see on the internet. It's like, you know, to hack better, you like NCIS, I think it was. Like, they were trying to counter hack a hacker. And their answer to out hacking the hacker was to have two people typing on the same keyboard. You know, it's that kind of things that I was expecting Mr. Robot to be, you know, about.
Yeah. It kind of, just hacking. Maybe like this guy who goes around hacking people for like, for justice or whatever, you know,
The introductory like dialogue that went along with it was like I don't like the world kind of thing. So I thought it was gonna be like, I'm an angry hacker person who's going to hack out of spite, you know. That's what I thought.
I think as well, it's really important before like talking about the show and like how it was marketed, is that the network it was on, you wouldn't think that was a network it would be on. You know?
It was definitely a step up in terms there's some lag there. I've watched shows on USA before, you know. It was definitely a step up in terms of production value and like quality of everything that the production was, you know.
Right. Yeah, exactly. And it kind of seemed like a bit edgy for those, like, cuz they don't want to do like comedy, you know, like lighthearted kind of like serious dramas, things like that. And I'm a wrestling fan, so when I watch Raw Live and watch the US feed of US Network, I'd always see these, like, Mr. Robot adverts, you know, and, like, I ended up watching, I had a marathon in the old show, like, once it had finished, and,
yeah.
Yeah, it was. It started off really well, and I've just got to say off the bat that I thought it was a great show. I really enjoyed it, the whole thing. I thought it was great.
Definitely. Like, I am a person who does not watch TV, like,
yeah,
pretty much at all. Like, you know, like, so, you know, I really went into Mr. Robot with very, very low expectations, and
the
final product just blew me away, and I was very, very pleased with the first season, and I can't wait for season two.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to continue. There is going to be a season two, and thankfully, and it's awesome. So if you have not seen Mr. Robot, without reading too much about it, and maybe this is the first time you're hearing us talk about it, and maybe this is the first you're kind of hearing about the show, but it's definitely worth going to check out if you can kind of find a way to kind of watch the season. I'm not sure what it's on. I think it may be Hulu. I'm not sure. But definitely check it out if you can. It's worth watching. It's just a really cool show. It's like, it's not just about hacking. I think that's what we're getting at the start of this.
It does. Yeah. I will say that the things that make it great are, A, it's the production value is very good. Like, the talent behind the scenes working on this, also along with a lot of good acting.
Yes.
Like, the cinematography is great. The attention to detail is amazing, which I think we'll get into later. But
oh, did I hit you?
No, you're good.
Okay, I've got the elevation machine because there's a blue patch up here that I want to get.
It's like, you know, a lot of top quality work that has gone into the production, and it's very smart about its product. It doesn't really treat the viewer as an idiot, so to speak, you know. It respects the viewer's attention. And it's easy to really write off a lot of the things that Mr. Robot introduces, but I highly recommend sticking with it. Even if you feel like it's veering off, don't worry, like, it veers back pretty well.
Yeah, it's kind of one of those shows that kind of you know, you kind of expect these kind of shows like this to kind of have like a story a week kind of thing, you know, like, oh, like, is he going to be hacking some, like, a different person every week? Is that how it's going to be?
Yeah.
The show is really, really not like that at all. So if you kind of like, if you're kind of going into this wanting kind of like a CSI style thing or anything like that, you're not going to get it really. I mean, they are kind of like touches of that in like certain episodes throughout the season.
That's what I was going to say is it feels like that, you know, it feels like they veer off again, but that stuff always has resolution. It's never just a one-off, you know. There's no wasted moments in the series.
Exactly. How do we get these blue lightning things out of the ground?
We need that gun. We'll do that after, because it can get messy.
All right.
Yeah.
But I think we can't really go on talk about this much longer without actually talking about plot details. So if you don't want to get spoiled, and we really recommend you don't. If you've not seen this show and you've got any mild interest in watching it, then just stop this video right now and just go and watch Mr. Robot, because we're going to get into plot details now and start spoiling everything, every major plot point.
If there's any fiber in your being where you're like, huh, this is interesting, don't even second guess it. Just go and find it and watch it. Yeah,
so the first thing I want to talk about is that the way this show handles twists, because it's like, the main twist that I personally called like two or three episodes into it.
You and the entire world.
everybody foresaw this coming. Everyone thought this was going to be the twist, and it was a twist, but it wasn't the twist at all.
It was a twist, but it was not a twist for the audience. And the cool thing about it is, A, the way they handled it, and B, the fact that they knew going into this that the viewers were going to pick up on it immediately, and they wove that into the narrative. And I really appreciated that. And that's what I mean by, like, they don't insult the viewer. They actually embrace that the average viewer is probably going to pick up on all these nuances and have an inkling of an idea. And, you know, some people, well, what's funny is I was watching this as it was, you know, being released, like, at the so I was constantly, you know, checking out, like, online forums and seeing how people were reacting, And I would say, like, the funny thing is there was a split in the audience where, like, some people were okay with going along with it. Other people felt cheated that they didn't have that told you so moment, you know,
right.
Which is kind of funny. But yeah.
I think we're going to have to start doing these ground things, man. I'm looking around and there's nothing for me to do.
Yeah, I'm doing
so. The twist we're talking about is obviously that Mr. Robot, the lead guy, is Elliot's. The twist is that it was you thought it was going to be it was going to be Elliot himself or like Elliot's father or something like that.
Yeah.
And it turns out that it was just Elliot the whole time. And it was kind of two twists there, right? Because there was like Elliot.
Yeah.
There was like Elliot. And Elliot's father, like, you know what I mean? Like, because when it first kind of started, and then it turned out it was like, because at first I thought, oh, Mr. Robot's obviously Elliot. That was like the first thing I thought of. Right. And then like it started twisting it, and I thought, oh god, wait, the twist is actually it's Elliot's father. And then it turns out, oh no, wait, it is actually Elliot. Like, it's like both of them.
Yeah.
It was like pretty confusing, but it was like just one of those twists that wasn't actually the main twist, and it was pretty well done. It's like we can't even explain it and give it justice, really. But
yeah, honestly, the thing I have to really give props to is Rami Malek, who plays Elliot.
Oh yeah,
he does a really good job at showing conflicted emotion. That like you feel the cogs like working, and you can see on his face the emotion of those moments, like the moments where he's starting to put it together when he's at the grave. And especially the moment where he, you know, finds the body, which I guess we can talk about later. But really enjoyed his performance. And I thought, like, when it first started out, I thought he was going to be, like, a very stoic, like, you know, just this monotone character. But then he has those emotional bursts. Like, when he figures out that Mr. Robot is his dad, and he's just like, this is the perfect time for me to be freaking out or whatever. I was just like, oh, such a good expression.
Yeah, he was really good, man. He's a really good actor. I can't even imagine anybody else in the role that he was playing, to be honest with you, by the end of it, or like at least a few episodes in. It was like, yeah, this guy's really cool and really plays the character well. And it was like, I think the whole cast was actually pretty good. And I'm terrible with names, so I'm going to forget names of characters and shit because I'm just terrible with character names. But What did you think of the girl in there, the blonde girl? Like, honestly, I'm so bad with names, man.
I think her name was Angela.
Yeah.
I'm actually intrigued with Angela. I think her character can go one of two ways. Either it seems like they're teasing that she's going to be embracing the whole corporate sort of, you know, dark side, I guess.
It ended with her, like, she was like working for the company, right? The big company at the end of it, wasn't she? Yeah. So pretty interesting. And there's also the other female lead who, you know, obviously spoiler, who ended up dying like halfway through, which I was sad about, man.
I wasn't a big fan of her.
At first of all, you know, who's this girl? But what the fuck? There's like a dead body down here, dude.
Oh yeah, we probably missed it.
Yeah, it's like as soon as we mention a dead body on the show, this shows up. I'm gonna have to like pick this up and try and carry this. Oh my god, how do we miss this, dude? All right, but yeah, that was really sad, man. When she died, that was fucked up. That whole story arc with the guy from prison was like messed up, man.
That entire thing was pretty tense. And again, That's the second moment where like Rami Malek had like a really good performance. Is like,
yeah, that was an amazing episode.
So yeah, so how it ends where, you know, the guy shows up, man, the girl was with you the whole time, and he, you know, points to the trunk, and it ends up being she was dead the whole time, and it's just like the camera refuses to pan down to the trunk.
You're just
seeing his emotion, and he's going through like cycles of emotion, and you're just like, She could be alive. Is she alive? Or, and then she's dead. It's like, oh man,
that whole scene was insane. That was like probably one of the more memorable episodes.
Yeah.
Just because of the ending was fucking crazy, and it actually had a pretty cool story too as well. Like, he had to, like, you know, break these fucking guys out of prison by hacking, you know. It's, that's just a cool storyline, you know. That's kind of like the, that was kind of like a thing, like a hacking of the week type thing. That was,
it was.
But
that just showed how ballsy Elliot was willing to be. He was just like, he did a lot of kind of like technically blackmailing. Like, he had the power all the time, but he was like, he wasn't afraid to express, pretty much out of desperation, really. But it's just like, you know, he was just like, yeah, I'm the hacker, you know, pretty much all the cards are in my hand, so.
And one of the first instances we saw of this was when he was blackmailing his psychiatrist, kind of the guy she was seeing. That was like right, pretty much at the start, man. And I'm a big fan of that psychiatrist, not only because she likes anal, but I mean, that was a great scene. Come on, that was an amazing scene when it finally, when he was in her office and he was like telling her all the shit about herself. I
and
thought
the crazy
that was
thing
great.
Is like, she's just staring dead blank when he mentions that. I'm just like, oh, that would probably be
and
my
that's the
expression.
Thing about the show. It like, it doesn't, it's like what you said earlier, it doesn't insult your intelligence. You'll tune in next week or like next episode, and like a week has literally passed in the show.
Yeah.
From that point, like, a lot of the time.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh. So, you know, it doesn't, like, pick up in her office for where it left last week, where you think, God, fucking hell, what did she say to that?
Yeah.
You're going to have to fill in the blanks of, like, what she said and what she did. And, you know, it's pretty cool like that. I like it.
Yeah. Oh, crap. It's, oh, God. Yeah, it's, I would say that my favorite thing, though, about the series in general is, and the thing that drew me to it was the fact that it was based around an unreliable narrator that
yes,
like you're saying, like, you know, like some things took place a week after. Hell, there were entire time skips in the show that we know nothing about, because you know, we're obviously seeing this through Elliot's perspective, basically.
Yeah, and let's talk about Elliot for a second, because the other key thing with his show is that I don't think a lot of people noodles get into is this is pretty much a show about this guy's illness, like mental illness.
Yeah, well, and that's the setup kinda, currently. Like,
yeah,
we're according to the creator, this is just like the tip of the iceberg. So
right,
yeah. So as much as it focuses on Elliot, and another guy I want to bring up is Tyrell, the other major.
Oh,
aspect
yeah,
of
we'll
this show.
Definitely talk about him.
But yeah, so it's like, you know, it's got this sort of dual thing going on, you know. I didn't mean to interrupt you, but yeah.
But yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, it's definitely like, cuz I, you know, I didn't know about this before when I started watching the show. The way it's like, you know, the way it's marketed really does not suggest that at all. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's but then when you watch it, it's fucking pretty deep, man. Like, it's, you know, it's pretty out there, like some of the shit that goes on. And, you know, if you're not how do I say this, like, if you just want kind of to watch a TV show just to fucking sit back and not really think too much about it, you're not really questioning anything, just like, you know, watch something for 45 minutes to escape, I don't think this is a show for you, man. You need to fucking, you know, pay attention, I feel like.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it does a good job of giving you the base, you know, narrative, but it really rewards you for sort of going a bit over, you know, sort of taking a second glance, if you will, because there's a lot of, like, a lot of nudges towards, you know, twists or things that come up later on in the series that you can sort of see coming if you really pay attention, you know.
Yeah,
and I really appreciated that. Again, that level of detail. And speaking of detail, the fact that, you know, they were so, like, very attentive to, like, technology in general, and you know,
just a quick interruption. How do we get rid of these marks on the floor?
These marks are, I think these are just here. This is where the blue stuff was, but
also we cannot remove these dents.
Yeah, I'm looking for bullet holes is my thing. You can pull out your sniffer thingy. I think it's 3 on the keyboard, and it'll show you different modes. I think the first one is blood, and the second one is like miscellaneous, the clutter that you can pick up in it'll go towards the 100%.
So it's going pretty crazy right here.
Yeah, so I think if you use the green one, you can use the green one to look for blood and then search for blood and clean it up. It might not even be blood, it might be like dirt or like grime. So yeah, it's stuff to look out for.
What the hell am I missing?
It might be in the plants or the bushes. This is a dark map, actually.
Yeah, it's pretty dark. I found a bunch of fucking footprints in the bushes down there.
Probably use a flare to help you. Oops.
Oh, there it is. There we go. Nice. I think we got it. Sweet. But anyway, as we was talking.
Oops.
So obviously the big, I'd say the big twist is that one of the main characters he introduced in the first episode or so turns out to be Elliot's sister.
Yeah.
That I did not fucking see that one coming. I'm not sure how many people did.
I don't think anyone saw it coming. I think again that was the creators knowing the audience that they were playing towards. I think they knew that people were going to be obsessed with trying to get the gotcha moment on Mr. Robot being
Dad,
that no one knew that I think Darlene was her name was the was the sister.
Yeah, that was crazy. So he tries to kiss this girl.
Yeah,
she pulls away, and you just think, "Oh, you fucked up now, Elliot, dude." She's clearly not into you like that. And then she starts saying, "Oh, do you know who I am?" And you're just thinking, like, what?
Yep.
You're like Elliot in this point, because you're thinking, what the fuck are you on about? Like, and then she's like, oh, God, you don't even realize, do you? And then she's like, oh, I'm your sister. And like, Elliot and everybody watching is thinking, what the fuck is going on?
Yep.
And turns out, and it's so interesting, because there's these little scenes throughout the series that just pop up with two characters talking to each other who wouldn't usually be talking to each other. And you're thinking, why the fuck are these two talking to each other?
Yeah.
Like, how do these know each other?
Yep.
Like, because Darlene was talking to Angela. What is it, Angela? Sorry, blonde one.
Yep.
Blonde chick. And, like, in the gym, and you're thinking, wait, these fucking two know each other?
Yeah.
Like, how do these know each other? You know what I mean?
Yep.
Like, well, turns out they know each other because Angela's known Elliot her whole life, and obviously she's known Elliot her whole life. She knows her sister. And then it all comes back to you, like, oh, that's... Then when it kind of reveals that she is a sister, you're kind of like, oh, well, fuck me, that's why.
Yep.
It's crazy, man. It was like... Oh, man, there's a bunch of USB sticks back here.
Oh, do you mean in the blue box?
No, there's like... Yeah, there's some... No, there's a bunch in the woods. There's a couple.
Ah.
Yeah, there's one more. But yeah, that was definitely... That was a big what the fuck moment, and I think that was the big twist it was kind of building towards as well.
I
he kind of used the other shit to kind of hide it.
Yeah,
and it did really well.
That was the moment where I was just verbally like, "What? What is happening right now?" Like, I was literally getting at my TV, like, "That?
Yeah,
what? I can't even fathom what just happened."
Yeah, crazy. But yeah, there was another like big character in the show who's definitely worth talking about, because he's like one of the best. And what's his name again? Like, I'm
pretty
so
sure his name is Tyrell.
What is it?
He's
It's like American Psycho, but not like American. It's like he's pretty fucked up.
Well, you say that, but I don't know, man. I gotta say, like, one of my favorite characters in the series is his wife.
Oh, yeah, she's great.
His wife, not only is she, like, probably one of the most beautiful people I've ever seen, but she plays such a crazy, scary character.
She's fucking psycho.
And she doesn't really do much. I mean, she what's the proper terminology? She
manipulates.
She broke her water purposely to get out of, talking to the cops. That's about the most extreme thing she does. The other thing she does, she really just strikes fear through simple conversation and the things she says, the way she says them. And I feel like she was the reason for Tyrell doing the insane things, like she was the one pressuring him to go after the position, which
yeah exactly
honestly led to one of my favorite cinematic moments in the show, where he goes to the guy, I think he was his competition, and he felt like he had the upper hand. And
oh, you just ran into me and killed me.
I did? What?
Yeah. Oops. Oh, you're on my corpse.
Wow, that's a crazy disconnect there.
That is weird.
I don't even see you.
Yeah, well, I'm back now. Yeah, there's always sync issues. I'm in front. Can you even see me? I'm in front of you.
I see you now.
Oh, okay.
I walked past you, but I thought we did it with a glancing pass. I didn't know I trampled you.
Yeah.
Oh, bullet hole. But yeah, so the scene, it starts with Tyrell looking very much like on par with the guy. But when you figure out in that scene later on that the guy has the upper hand, the way it's shot is like Tyrell is barely even in the frame of the shot. Like he's at the bottom, I think bottom left of the entire exchange. I mean, brilliant scene. It's things like that that I think sort of play towards his characters. He's obviously doing all of this mostly because out of love for his wife, but also because he probably enjoys the...
Yeah, he also does beat up homeless people.
Yeah.
And it's pretty fucked. And at the moment, he's gone missing, so we don't know what happened to that guy.
Yeah, with the whole time jump.
There's a big time jump, which is pretty much the cliffhanger, and you don't know what the fuck's going on.
Yeah.
But, But overall, pretty awesome show. There's definitely a lot to look forward to in season 2.
Ah, damn it. I just want to clear these holes. Stupid black smudge. God damn it. Yes, I'm interested to see, like they were saying, so Elliot's story is really just the tip of the iceberg. I'm curious to know where it goes from here. Because again, as much as I want to say that Tyrell is in on it now, the scenes that bug me is, obviously there's a scene where Mr. Robot is in the same car as Tyrell. So is that a fabrication? Yeah. Or was that... Does Tyrell know that Elliot suffers from, you know, like a split personality disorder, whatever the hell it is, and he's exploiting that? Because he acts with Elliot like he's never known about this until the end of the first season. So
yeah,
but from the discussions with Mr. Robot is they had a deal
exactly,
in place.
Yeah.
So
because that's when you're thinking, what the fuck? Because when Mr. Robot goes and has goes and sits down and talks to him, you're thinking, why are these two talking to each other?
Yeah, like how do they even know each other?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's pretty crazy. But man, I think we're pretty much done this map, dude. I think we are.
I don't know, man. We have to go over with the sensor. I'm pretty sure we missed a lot. Like I'm looking over here. Yeah, I'm getting like a lot of green spikes here. So there's something over here we didn't clean.
What?
The thing with Viscera is it's very finicky. So like one little patch of blood or whatever will set off the thing.
Alright, I'm gonna have a look around.
Looks like that might have
I found some. I found some! There we go. These fucking machines. Oh god.
Did you go over the entire area with the sniffer thing?
Yeah, I'm doing it right now. There's a few hidden footsteps actually back here. Let me see. So far, so good.
Yeah. So I don't know. Like, what do you expect, or what do you hope for in season 2? Like,
so he kind of left off where Elliot's kind of like the front guy of this kind of hacking group now, right? Is that what happened?
I don't remember. It's been so long. I know that the entire ending bit was Mr. Robot making a speech.
Exactly. Yeah.
But did that happen? Wasn't he like?
Yeah. Was he hallucinating? I don't even know, man.
Yeah. I think he was hallucinating at least some of it.
Hmm.
But well, actually, for the, one thing, there was, I mean, there was the post-credit scene, which is what I wanted to allude to.
Right.
So, White Rose,
which is
the character that,
yeah.
Again, as when I was talking about, you know, they were really paying attention to detail. Did you know that the character of White Rose seems to be loosely based on an actual hacker?
Yeah, I read this, yeah.
Yeah, so, and you know what? I'm hoping that it's being progressive and not using the fact that White Rose is transgender to, because White Rose shows up in a post-credits, or like, I guess it's post-credits scene, dressed up as a man, but obviously, you know, White Rose seems to identify as a woman.
Right.
Which, by the way, I love the White Rose character. Like, her obsession with time is so, speaks to me so much. I'm just like, yes, finally a character that treats time the same way I do. But anyway, so yeah.
She's definitely one of the, she's definitely one of the bad characters.
I really hope we see more of White Rose, but, yeah, so it's interesting, like, where does White Rose play into the whole thing? Because obviously she's part of the, I don't know, not Illuminati, but whatever the hell this, you know, group of wealthy old people, whatever.
Yeah, I think that's definitely what the season 2 is going to be obviously kind of focused on, or at least kind of have at least an arc based on.
Yeah.
She's definitely one of the more interesting characters because... Didn't she say that you'll never see me again as soon as I walk out his door?
Yeah.
So, like, it's crazy. I don't understand, like... the good thing about Season 2, it could literally go anyway. You just don't even know what's going to happen, like... I honestly can't even tell. I can't even say what I want to see. Like, what I'm going to see. It's just... I'm just excited for it, man. As long as it kind of maintains the quality of Season 1, I'm pretty hyped for it.
Well, here's my question is... Would you be annoyed if they dropped, like, the unreliable narrator and they went a more traditional route? Do you think that would...
I think I would be disappointed, but I can't see them ever doing that, ever. There's no way they would drop anything. I don't think they're going to really make many changes, right? I mean, I've not really read too much about it, but as far as I understand, it's, like, pretty much going to be... the same, hopefully it's the same kind of standard that we've come to kind of expect, because it wouldn't be a shame. Oh, I'll tell you what I did fucking hate, and this is just more of a network issue, and that was the fact that it fucking bleeped out every swear word, man.
Even if you
got the web down, even if you like watched it online, like not on network, it was the same shit. It kind of just senses out of the world. I think you got to maybe wait for the Blu-ray for maybe. Maybe they won't be putting the Blu-ray. But, yeah, man. That bothered me so much. But that was a network issue.
Yeah.
Oh, there's some stuff here.
There's a body part here somewhere.
Yeah, there's a pancreas next to me.
Yeah.
Can you pick the other one up? There's another one.
There is?
Yeah, it's right next to me.
Oh, shoot. They're bullet casing. Oh, man. There's a lot of trash over here. There was a trash bin over here somewhere.
Yeah, there's one over here.
Yeah. Yeah, bring it over. We'll get the remains. Yeah.
Where is it?
Over here.
I'll put it down here.
Nope.
Did I even put that in?
No, I think I grabbed it from you.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I couldn't see them hand. I was like, where is it? I think we're done here.
I don't know, maybe? I'm still getting some beeps over here. So there was something else.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's gotta be.
Oh, yeah, I'm getting loads.
Well, we're near the trash bin. The trash bin.
Ah, yeah, we're good. You're right. It was probably that. Wait, I'm getting it again. Oh, wait, there's a big pancreas. There's still a cock thing.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, there it is. You got it. There we go.
All right.
All right. Man, I would say we're pretty close here.
This place, are you still getting beeps? Pretty good.
This is the last time we are playing this map. We are trying to get as much done as possible before we wrap this up.
I'm happy with like a 90%. If we can get a 90% on this.
I think we're there, dude.
We missed something back here.
Oh, wait, where are you?
Sort of in the trees across from the sign.
Oh, I see you're thinking about it. Yeah.
Oh. There's a whole bunch of...
Oh, you killed me again.
What?
You ran into me and killed me. God, why am I always dead?
I'm like the pain train.
Look at this shit. Look at me. What is going on? That's the thumbnail. Me resting in peace. Did you just come and try and sweep me up?
I'm trying to get whatever the hell is back here.
Alright. I'm coming back. I can't see anything back there. I've like been sweeping up back there and everything. Maybe it's like a thumb drive or something? Fork knives.
It's probably somewhere. Somewhere.
I swear these footprints just like turn up like mid game.
Yeah.
Why is like this random odd footprints? Maybe something hidden behind this thing. Okay, I'm gonna put a flammable barrel. What do we do with these flammable barrels? Can we just do stuff, stack them up, or what?
Usually you can just leave them and they should be okay.
Alright, go put it back. I'll put it down here somewhere. Here we go.
I'm trying to follow the leads or whatever the hell it is. Something over here. In the trees, maybe?
Oh, blood. Got it. I'm just gonna fucking start just mopping the floor. Just like randomly.
Oh my god. How do we miss this? Joe, come here.
Where are you?
I'm back where I accidentally ran you over. In the trees.
Okay, I see you.
Look up here.
Up?
Up.
My dear god!
How do we miss this?
No! Oh, god.
I'm looking
damn
at the
it.
Floor like, where's the blood? Oh!
How do we get them down?
Yeah, okay, this place is gonna get a little dirty, probably.
It's alright.
Oh, god.
I got him down. There we go.
Try to, like, pick them up by the butt or something, so they don't splash around. Oh, my God. Oh.
Oh, there's blood.
Where'd he go?
Bloody footprints everywhere.
Ah, no, the body disappeared from me. Oh, there it is.
No, that's not good.
Damn it, lag. Or desync.
Oh, that is fucked up, man.
All right. I got one in.
I can't see shit. I can't see anything. I'm just following. I'm looking up. I think I'm on the stairs. Oh, man. That is unfortunate, dude.
Imagine if we punched out. We're like, yeah, we cleaned up the entire place.
Yeah. Oh, there's blood everywhere.
Yeah.
Fuck. Well, that's one way to end it. Once we've done this, I'm logging out no matter what. I'm done with this map. I think we've done everything at least.
Oh man, we gotta clean to perfection, man.
Jesus, I don't know how much more we can do.
Well, obviously, if there's still bodies in the trees, we're gonna have to...
Yeah, I'm gonna start looking up.
Alright. Seems okay over here.
Yeah, just look up. Maybe there's some back here on this other side. How did they even get in the trees?
Jungle monsters, man. They'll find a way.
I know. Apparently. I think we're good. I honestly think we're good. I'm ready to call it. I feel like we've done enough. I can't find anything else. Oh, wait, there's a footprint back here. There we go.
Hold on. Something on the stairs. What's on the stairs? Let's watch these stairs. Still here? Okay, what's hiding?
Fuck.
There's something by the stairs. What secrets are you hiding, stairs?
There's always something by the stairs. Oh my fucking god. Alright.
What the heck? Oh, there we go. It's on the pillar.
Sweet.
Okay.
Careful, I'm coming
through. Whoa.
Get in there, you piece of shit. There we go. Alright, I think we're there, dude. I think we're there.
Whoa. Hold on.
Oh my god, what now?
It's on the trees? Still getting huge spikes of blood somewhere.
Really?
I think I got it. Nope. What is on the stairs here? I don't see anything on the stairs.
Let me see if I can see. Maybe some desync issue. On the stairs? Let me pull out my thing.
It's like right here somewhere.
Oh, there's a pancreas thing next to you, dude.
Oh.
Look.
Oh, I didn't see that.
There we go.
That explains that. Alright. One more area to look at.
Alright, yeah, let's zap these last few parts.
Yeah, I would like to know other people's opinions on the on Mr. Robot. Like, what do you guys think?
Yeah, definitely.
It was a pretty wild ride seeing how people were reacting on a per episode basis. I would like to know, like, if anybody else watched it, you know, or how many of you were the people who were like, I called it, I knew it was Mr. Robot, and then got angry.
Yeah.
When that wasn't the most important part. All right.
Yeah, I've got to say, one of the cool things as well was the episode where it kind of started with Elliot as a kid, and then it panned out to the logo, and there's actually the name of the store that his father worked at. I thought that was cool.
The other cool thing about that, too, is, the attention to detail is... So every time they show the Mr. Robot, it shows written by... I forget his name. Under it. And in that particular episode, it's the same shade as the Mr. Robot logo.
Yeah.
It's not like a default
really
red.
Cool.
Oh, crap. Wait, something over here. Come towards the entrance area. The pipe.
Oh, fuck, there's something in... Oh, wait, hold on. There's some on the fucking machine, dude. I think.
Nope. Maybe I got it. Nope.
Oh, there's still something here. Where is it? Is that actually in the machine? Like... I'm fucking stuck. Oh, God. Get the fuck up. Ah! Here we go. Dude, what is going on here? Where is it?
There's blood somewhere over here.
There's fucking blood somewhere over there, apparently, but I can't see shit. This game's playing tricks on us now, man.
Oh, I think I got it. Nope, I didn't get it. It's something right here. Where I'm standing.
Oh, it's another pancreas! Dude, are you blind to these pancreas things?
Dude, I don't see them.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
There's like just turds. Maybe there's one down here. Maybe that's what we're doing here. Maybe it's a turd on the floor. Hidden turds.
I'm pretty sure it's a desync issue.
Yeah, there must be something going on there with that. Alright, man. Are you ready to call this? We need to check out and see our progress.
Where was the other machine that you were having?
It was where the on the bucket machine. But I can't see shit.
Oh, yeah.
Apparently.
Oh.
So I don't know if it's, like, inside the machine. I don't know. I'm just going to scrub it. Look it.
Maybe on top?
Oh wait. It's like around this side. I can't see anything. It's not very high.
Huh.
Yeah, oh, it's here. I think it's on the back side. I've got it. Wait, that's like part of the machine. That won't come off.
Oh, we need another med pack there.
Yeah, that is weird, man. Oh, dear. Oh, God.
What the? Why don't you give me a flyer? Don't give me a flyer.
So is, like, Mr. Robot actually going to return? Because he's still part of, like, Elliot's, like, mind and stuff, right?
I'm pretty sure he's going to come back, but obviously his role will be different. Like, we won't see him talking to the group, I imagine. Well, maybe he will, but Elliot will obviously know what's going on now. But,
yeah.
It's going to be... That's, I think, the most intriguing part is how do they handle, you know, the situation going forward.
Right.
Hmm.
Oh, there's some... Oh, there's fucking litter all over this section. Dude, get me a waste bin. Actually, I'll get one right next to it. There's always something, isn't there? Fucking hell. Alright, I've got some bunch of shit. Rubbish everywhere, dude. Hidden in the corner. Potato chips. Fucking cans of pop. Get in there. Alright, I'm 100% convinced that is it now. That is everything. I'm putting this in the incinerator and I'm getting ready to clock out, dude. We've done our duty. If we don't get a 90% on this, I'll be fucking shocked.
Well, we're probably not going to because there's something wrong with this machine.
Yeah, it's really bizarre, that is. I can't see what is over there.
Might be something...
What is the brush?
The brush is usually done for, like, finer stuff. I think. Oh, this is driving me nuts. What?
There's nothing on it, dude. Oh god, I've opened a thing. Get back up. Get back up! It's not on the walls. There's nothing up there, dude.
Apparently it's right here.
Is it on top of the machine?
Oh, it's like this spot. For some reason this spot is going crazy. Oh wait, is that it?
Oh, I see it, I see it.
There it is.
There's something blood. In there.
Blood.
Here it is.
Again, that was, like, invisible to me this entire time.
Yeah, I could not see that either. Alright.
There's still some blood here somewhere.
What? Oh my god. This is the OCD to game, man. I am like...
Oh, we still didn't get it. There's still something here.
Oops. No, there's not. I'm done. I can't think of anything. There's nothing here, dude. There is literally zero. Oh wait, is that a pan? Is that a?
There's
that?
Something here. Yep,
I got it. I think I pushed it away.
Oh, I see the blood.
Oh, there's all blood around me.
There,
there's something. There's
there,
a fucking. There's
there
a piece
is.
Of.
It's a
oh, you got it. You got something. It. Jesus, man.
That was like in the floor or something.
It was. Alright, dude, that has got to be it. That is it. That has got to be it.
Let's see.
Yeah, there's nothing else here, dude. There's nothing else. Oh my god, the machine is working fine.
Alright, let's get rid of these buckets. Make sure,
yeah.
Yeah,
you take one, I'll take the other. There's a couple back here. Alright, I've got it. Wait, there's something on... There's a bullet on the floor.
Ah.
Can you see it?
Hold on.
You got it.
Oops.
Oh. Put it in. Oh, no, you can't do that. Ah.
Huh? Why?
Did it go in?
Yeah.
I thought I heard it click on the floor.
No, I'm pretty sure it's in there.
Oh, sweet. Oh, it is in there. Yeah, it just doesn't make a sound with water. Here we go. Alright, I think there's one more book here and then we can log out of this fucking place. I'm not gonna miss this map.
Well, we did start with like one of the big maps.
Yeah, this is... I think it's actually even bigger maps than this, so...
This is a cleanup, man.
That's true. I'm shutting the incinerator. What?
I have to tell you, but we've missed a lot of debris. We are not going to get a 90. No.
Where?
This place alone is going crazy. There's debris somewhere around here. If you switch to the purple one...
Yeah, I'm on it. I can't see anything.
Yeah.
There's nothing here, though.
Could it be in the trees? In the rocks? Man, we did not think we would have this much to clean up.
It's going crazy over here. Oh my god.
We never had to throw these... I have never had to throw these barrels away before. Maybe I have... We have to?
Hey, there's something still going crazy.
Nothing back here. Oops.
Oh, God, dude. Oh, the smoke.
Oh, God.
That is not good. Oh, my God. I'm in the smoke. I think we've just burnt the floor.
Oh, my bad.
There's smoke. Well, oh, dude. You fucked up big time.
Oh. Okay, so we don't incinerate those. So what the heck did we miss? I mean, there's nothing in this area, but it's still going crazy.
Oh my god, now my bro... Oh, dude. Fuck. We've just fucked up. There's blood on the back of the thing now. I need to get a book here.
Wait, how did blood get back there?
I was cleaning the smoke and it just started bloody.
Oh.
I don't know why. If this gives me a body part, I swear. Alright, we're good.
I don't see that much smoke.
Yeah, it's good. We just need to clean the blood up. Alright, let's just do it. We've got to call it. We've got to.
That's so weird.
We've got to do it. Alright, dude. I think we've got everything here, at least. I feel like we've stained the ground completely with that explosion. I don't know. But
no, that's just the shadows from the trees.
We don't need this for anything, do we? So we can put this in.
Yeah.
And close this. Oh my god, look how black this is now. There we go.
Yeah, that's really weird, like... I don't understand.
Alright, let's go and log out, dude. We're doing it. We've got to call it. Let's activate this.
This map makes no sense. Make
your choice. I wish I could do more for my company. Give me some paperwork to fill out the extra marks. I'm proud of my performance and certain it will meet with approval. I'm going to click that one.
No, that's a lie.
Why? We've done well.
Not according to the sniffer.
Well, which one shall I pick?
I don't know.
Wish I could do more for my company. Give me some paperwork to fill out for extra marks.
I don't know.
I don't want to fill out paperwork. What is the only one is I don't care.
Paperwork.
I'm proud of my performance. I'm proud. I'm proud. We've done good. I'm clicking it. Screw it.
I'm not proud.
We're going back to the office. Does it give us a mark or anything?
Yeah, it's going to show on the board.
Okay, well, I'm in.
Stuck.
Dude.
Stuck. Yep, we got an 82%.
I know, I'm disappointed. Well, fuck. 82%, that sucks.
I mean, you know, that was our first job. We'll do better in the next job.
Yeah, that's true. There's a lot of trees in that place.
Dude, that level was bullcrap anyway.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of it was bugged. I think there's some serious desync going on. I don't know.
Yeah, I really didn't see anything that I could pick up, so...
Yeah. Right. But there it is. I guess that is the conclusive chapter on Overgrowth. Or Overgrown, whatever it's called. And yeah, we've had a fun run. So I guess next time we fire this up, we're going to be playing a completely different map. So that'll be good, at least. I'm glad, to be honest with you.
Probably going to get a demotion. Bosses are going to be happy.
Nope. But hey, I think we did pretty well. Maybe.
Yeah. It was alright.
It was alright. But yeah, there it is, guys. That is our kind of Mr. Robot cleanup cast, I guess you could call it.
Oh, hey, look, a great way to go out. It's got like the Matrix going on this computer.
Well, there it is. So yeah, we can look at the Matrix. What happens if you click this?
I think you just grab it.
Nope.
Nope.
Network. Dude, there's like different files and stuff. What are you doing? I'm trying to access these files.
Oh.
Private. Forbidden. Access denied. Oh.
Oh.
I can find someone's porn. Skynet. This is nothing wrong with your terminal ID. Do not attempt to adjust the display when our control of the system. yeah. But here it is. Thanks for watching, guys. Apparently Skynet's taken over. We'll see you next time.
Call the hackers. Hack the planet. Bye.
See ya.